And wrapping up our news this Wednesday, more than 500,000 kids in the U.S. are visually impaired. Teaching kids who are blind how to read Braille can sometimes be a challenge. But as reporter Lindsay Boat shows us, a new tool from a well-known company is getting into the hands of teachers to help kids learn how to read and keep it fun.
Normally, when you think of Legos, you think of bricks like this. They can come in kits with instructions to make spaceships or cars, or you can freestyle and make things on your own. Well, now the Lego Foundation has come up with a way to use these classic toys to help kids who are visually impaired learn how to read.
So a Braille cell has 6 dots, 3 on one side and 3 on the other. And the configuration of those dots is a different letter.
Legos come in a variety of shapes and sizes, like this, a 2x4.
What they did is removed the bottom 2 studs and put in print, and then the top 6 studs are basically what you would have in a Braille cell.
This particular brick with the 1 stud on the left and 2 on the right is a D or a 4. They both have the same dot pattern. Kate Herndon is with the company that's distributing the brick kits, and she shared this video with us. The kits have gone out to teachers all across the country and in 20 other countries as well.
I don't think I have used them with a student who didn't like them.
One of those teachers is Paige Maynard. She was one of the first to get one of the kits. It comes with 300 bricks, and there are letters, numbers, punctuation marks, and math symbols to allow kids to create words, sentences, and math equations, and there's a baseboard for the Legos to snap into.
It's that other thing that us as teachers of the visually impaired can use to help our students with progressing with their skills in literacy.
And kids as young as 4 are learning from these Braille bricks. One of Maynard's 9-year-old students loves Disney princesses, so she came up with a game where she was Ariel from The Little Mermaid and the bricks were seashells.
She was finding the ones that were the same, putting them in her seashell purse.
Maynard says not only is it fun for the kids, it's another tool in the toolbox that teachers of the visually impaired can use.
We think about a lot of students who are print readers, and you know, they have all of their alphabet manipulatives that, you know, have been around for years. But children who are visually impaired and Braille readers haven't really had that in the past. And you know, if they have, it's just not been as widely available.
Learning Braille is so very important. And this is one way, one method to reinforce the learning that's taking place in the classroom to bring play into it, to make it fun, to make it more motivating for kids.
The classic Lego bricks that have been around for almost 90 years, putting those interlocking bumps to another good use. I'm Lindsay Boach reporting.
Legos are lots of